most amazing skyscrapers in the world. Hey everyone, it's Alexa and welcome back to another video. What makes a building a skyscraper? According to good old Wiki, a skyscraper can hold the title of a skyscraper if it is taller than 150 meters and has over 40 floors. It wasn't always the case though, and during the late 1800s it included any building that had between 10 and 20 floors, but the bar was raised as technology and building methods improved. Our list today has a look at some tall and some not so tall skyscrapers from around the world. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Shanghai World Financial Center, Shanghai, China. Located in the Pudong district of Shanghai is this 494-meter skyscraper, officially the second tallest tower in the world. The building is state-owned and has the fastest elevators in the world. They go 74 kilometers an hour. The unique design reduces wind pressure and pays reference to Chinese mythology. You can spend a night in the highest hotel room in the world right here. 30 St. Mary Axe, London, United Kingdom. A trip to London will not be complete if you don't pay a visit to this iconic building. It's earned the nickname Gherkin and is shaped like a bullet. It boasts 41 stories and is roughly 180 meters tall. The current occupants are Swiss Re, a global insurance company. The contemporary architecture is recognized globally, and the shape allows for the smooth flow of wind around the building. 7,429 panes of glass were used to build this beauty. Aqua, Chicago. Chicago is home to Aqua, an 82-story tower that sits in the Lakeshore East development in downtown. The tower features gardens, gazebos, hot tubs, swimming pools, and a running track and fire pit. The balconies are huge and sprawl outwards up to 12 feet. The building combines office space, residential homes, shops, and hotel rooms, and the green roof on the top is one of the largest in Chicago. Ice 2, Canada. These residential high-rises are based in Toronto and are the second of the Ice series condominium skyscrapers leaning heavily on Scandinavian design. The towers stand at 202 meters and 234 meters, respectively. One is 57 floors and the other 67 floors. It won the Empress Skyscraper Award in 2016 as one of the best skyscrapers in the world. Bosco Verticale, Milan, Italy. Another set of residential towers based in Italy makes the list because it's covered in 900 trees. And although it doesn't quite make the skyscraper cut, we had to slip it in because of its unique features. It's 111 meters, and over and above the 900 trees, there are 5,000 shrubs and 11,000 other plants, helping to mitigate the smog and produce oxygen. The Shard, London, England. This is officially the tallest completed building in the UK and stands at 309.5 meters and is the 105th tallest building in the world. It has the highest observatory in London. What makes this building even more impressive is that 95% of the materials used are recycled. Bank of China Tower, Hong Kong, China. It's one of the most recognizable landmarks in Hong Kong and stands at a dazzling 305 meters tall. When the building was constructed, there was quite a bit of controversy surrounding it. It was one of the few buildings in Hong Kong that bypassed the norm of having the feng shui masters in on the design before the building went up. Many don't approve of the sharp lines and X shapes in the original design, though. Scandic Victoria Tower, Stockholm. This is a 117 meter tall hotel in the northwestern part of Stockholm and officially the tallest hotel in Scandinavia. Over 8,000 panels of glass were used to create the flawless design with its hammerhead top and is equipped with a fitness center, meeting rooms, bars, restaurants, and it's the perfect place to meet, socialize, and interact. 432 Park Avenue, USA. New York City is where you'll find the third tallest building in the US, the second tallest in New York, and the tallest residential building in the world. Overlooking Central Park, 432 is not loved by all residents, many citing it as an eyesore. It is 425.5 meters tall and has 96 floors. 90% of the apartments are owned by non-Americans. One World Trade Center, New York, USA. This is the tallest building in the USA and stands proud at 541.3 meters and cost $3.9 billion to build. It also goes by the name of Freedom Tower and is the main building that was rebuilt in the World Trade Center complex. The glass panels and the shape of the structure give it a kaleidoscope effect, which changes color throughout the day depending on the angle of the sun. Torre Glories, Barcelona, Spain. This 38-story tower is located in Barcelona and is shaped like a geyser climbing into the air. The building was owned by the multinational group Agbar, but Merlin Properties Real Estate Group bought it in 2017 and renamed it. It has received a Green Building Award in 2011 for its low CO2 emissions and energy efficiency. Bitexco Financial Tower, Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam. This beautiful skyscraper is in Ho Chi Minh City and represents the lotus, the national flower of Vietnam. It used to be the tallest building in Vietnam, but it's been surpassed by Khiang Nam Hanoi Landmark Tower. The building is 262.5 meters and is mainly used for office space by Bitexco Group. D1 Tower, UAE. It's not the tallest tower in Dubai and only comes in as the 32nd tallest tower in Dubai. The aim of the design was to combine the rich Middle Eastern heritage with the technology of today. There are 80 floors in the building, which stands at 284 meters tall. There's a skyrise lounge, indoor pool, a private cinema, and a gymnasium, just to highlight some of the luxuries of this exclusive apartment block. F&F Tower, Panama City. This impressive skyscraper also won an award for being one of the most distinctive structures built and stands at 240 meters. It ranked 7 out of the 10 Empress Skyscraper Award winners, and it's made up of paneled glass that reflects the sun during the day. It's also called the Twist Scraper due to, well, you guessed it, the spiraling shape of the skyscraper. Kingdom Center, Riyadh, Saudi Arabia. It stretches for 41 stories and reaches heights of 302 meters, and it's where you'll find some of the most luxury brands in the world, plus a 5-star hotel and the Sky Bridge. The bridge connects each side of the tower and offers the most surreal views of the city of Riyadh. The kingdom is covered in a special kind of glass wrap, protecting it from the intense heat and sun common in the area. The Petronas Towers, Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. This is the tallest twin building in the world and reaches 451.9 meters in height. The towers are mainly office space and shops with an observation deck connecting them. The towers were the tallest in the world between 1998 and 2004. The towers have actually made a guest appearance in Phineas and Ferb. Messeturm, Frankfurt. Completed in 1990, this tower held the honor of being the tallest building in Europe from 1991 until 1997. The Commerzbank Tower took that title in 97. Its length is 257 meters and it has its own postal code. It's an office block located in the center of Frankfurt and it's easy to spot, not only because it's so tall, but it's also shaped like a giant pencil. Empire State Building in New York, USA. One of the most famous landmarks in the world is the Empire State Building located in the center of Manhattan. It was the result of a race to create the world's tallest building. The purpose of the building was to house offices, but that didn't quite go to plan with the 1929 stock market crash and the beginning of the Great Depression. 75% of the building remained empty until 1931, and it was often called the Empty State Building. It is 102 stories and is 443 meters tall. Mercury City Tower, Moscow. This super tall skyscraper is the tallest in Europe and rises 338.8 meters. It was designed by the late American architect Frank Williams and cost in the region of $1 billion. The glass has a slight pink tinge to it, which wasn't the original idea. They originally hoped to clad the building in a sheath of silver glass, which would act as a mirror to the surrounding city buildings. It never panned out, but is now this permanent shade of sunset pink. Cocoon Tower, Tokyo. What makes this beautiful skyscraper stand out from our previous ones is that it's one of the few buildings that are used as an educational facility as opposed to offices or residential space. It accommodates 10,000 students, and inside is a fashion school, an information and technology school, and a medical welfare school. It is 203.7 meters tall and is the 33rd tallest building in Japan. Marina Bay Sands, Singapore. Completed in 2010, Marina Bay Sands is truly magnificent. It's home to the world's longest elevated swimming pool, holding a ton of water. Literally, a ton of water. There are also hotels, a casino, museum, movie theater, shopping mall, and one of the most expensive restaurants in the world. It's regular to see two people enjoying their dinner and being presented with a bill of $2,000. There's a fourth tower in the pipeline as well. The Bow, Calgary. This is the second tallest office tower in Calgary and stands at 236 meters tall. Azure Magazine ranked it as part of its top 10 architectural projects in the world in 2012. Construction was stopped for a while when they had a $400 million deficit in their budget, but they forged ahead despite the shortfall and did put the second tower on hold indefinitely. Via 57 West, New York. Manhattan, New York is where you'll come across this pyramid-shaped tower block that is 142 meters in length and consists of 35 stories. It's a luxury apartment building that was recently crowned the best new skyscraper in the world. The building recycles 60,000 gallons of water every month. It costs $2,600 a month to rent the smallest unit of this apartment block. Burj Khalifa, Dubai, UAE. A list of skyscrapers would never be complete without including the tallest in the world, the Burj Khalifa, which stretches 830 meters in height. If you had to disassemble the tower and lay the pieces out, it would span a quarter way across the world. The Burj holds other titles too, including the tallest freestanding building in the world, the highest number of stories, the highest occupied floor, highest observation deck, and an elevator that travels the farthest. Alhambra Tower, Kuwait City. This beautiful tower is the tallest building in Kuwait and was named one of the best inventions in 2011 by Time magazine. It's 414 meters tall and was constructed with malleable concrete as opposed to traditional steel. Jinmao Tower, Shanghai. This used to be the tallest building in China but was surpassed by the Shanghai World Financial Center. It has 88 stories and is 420 meters tall. The building comprises office space, food courts, conference and banquet facilities, a shopping mall, eating establishments, and nightclubs. We have just one more to go, but before we get there, we've got to ask you guys, would you ever be brave enough to go to the top story of any of these skyscrapers? Or have you been fortunate enough to visit any of them? If so, share your experiences with us in the comments below. 1. Taipei 101, Taipei. It held the title of the largest building in the world until 2010 when the Burj Khalifa opened. It has 101 floors, hence the name, and although it's not the tallest building in the world anymore, it still holds the title for the largest and highest use green building in the world. It's 509.2 meters tall and can withstand typhoons and earthquakes.